What this bill does is pretty self-explanatory in the title. January, if this bill is passed into law, will become Americans of Chinese Descent History Month. When the concept for this bill was first brought to me, I was frankly surprised that we didn't have a way to honor this segment of our citizens in statute. In fact, if this passes into law, we will be the first state to so honor our citizens. The bill does not dictate anything to our schools, but it simply serves as a reminder that they should take some time during the month of January to teach about the history, the trials, and the tribulations that Americans of Chinese descent have endured. And it makes sense for Washington State, because our history with the Chinese and Americans of Chinese descent has some dark things that we need to live up to, but it also has some amazing accomplishments where that community has contributed to our state. We need to acknowledge all of those things in an open and pragmatic way. And this bill gives us a chance to reflect on that once a year and to teach our school children the important role that Americans of Chinese descent have played in our history. And it's a natural fit for Washington State. Most of you are aware of the Chinese Exclusion Act, which prohibited Chinese from immigrating to this country. But do you know that the Magnuson Act was the act that began to reverse that racist policy? Senator Magnuson, Washington State Senator, was a sponsor of that legislation. I think that's important history. Think about the fact that Governor Locke, Ambassador Locke, the ambassador to China, was the first American of Chinese descent to be governor of a state in the continental United States. That was history that happened right before our eyes. So I think this bill is appropriate for Washington to be first. And I want to thank everybody who had a piece in this. This bill has been described as Senator Wagoner's bill, and nothing could be further from the truth. This bill was brought to me in a grassroots movement by Asians for Equality, and I have to give personal thanks to Linda Yang, who trusted me to bring this bill to the floor, and I appreciate all the help that I got to get it here today. Please vote yes.